Yeah, right. So in the first 10 years, the foundation has laid a lot of the groundwork on, you know, what is circular economy? Why does it matter? What's the business case of circular economy? And I think we're now at the point where many organizations, companies, governments, etc., are starting to implement seriously on circular economy and thinking, what does it mean for my organization or my industry? And once you start implementing something, you need to know where you're at today, what you're actually implementing, so where you want to go, and how fast you're moving between those two states, how much, you know, the work that you're putting into is getting you from where you are today to the circular economy that you want to be in the future. And data and being able to measure is what is needed to do just that.
So what I hear that particularly for the companies, for them, in order to be effective at circular economy implementation, they need to know where they want to get and measure their performance towards that. And right. That's what Circulytics would be providing.
Yeah, exactly. And as you said, we've tried to build Circulytics in a way where it's applicable to different industries, different companies of different sizes, in a way that helps hopefully companies to see areas of development, areas of strength, and in that way then prioritize actions to become more circular in the future.
Mm-hmm. And Tom, as a guest from one of our global partners, so a company who is trying to implement circular economy and at the forefront of that, why does it matter for you to think about data and metrics within DS Smith?
So from a circular economy perspective, the world's resources have never been more overstretched. It just makes good business sense to start, you know, keep materials in use to restore natural systems. So, you know, we're under a huge amount of pressure from consumers, from customers, and just regulatory pressure too. And we're all moving away from linear models. So it makes sense for us to start to really enhance our model. So you did a great job of introducing Ilma, but for those who I've never heard of DS Smith. We operate a 14-day box-to-box model, where we can make, use, collect, and recycle cardboard packaging within 14 days. That's supported by a circular business model where we have recycling divisions responsible for collecting all of that material and taking it to our paper mills for reprocessing. They send the recycled paper through to our packaging plants who make brand new boxes and packaging out of it and send it on to the retailer. So we have that strong circular model, but you know, there's a saying of what gets measured gets managed. So you know, to live our purpose, which is to redefine packaging for a changing world, we must understand where we can improve. So we have a strong foundation, but we must develop our strategy there to be future fit and competitive in the coming decade.
So what other stakeholders were involved in the process then?
Yeah, well, indeed, Tom put it well. So indeed, we did try to involve, you know, organizations of different sizes from different industries to make sure that it fits different, you know, contexts, and so that was really a key to developing it. And now we are at the place where we have 400 companies signed up since its launch in the first month, and we hope to get more feedback and figure out what version 2.0 should be like that we are planning to launch late this year.
Okay, 500 companies, and that's just in the last
400.
400,
but it could be closing to 500. Now I have a number from late last week.
So. In a few weeks, that's quite impressive.
Yeah, it just shows how much interest there is from different types of organizations to measure about, you know, their performance in circular economy and how circular economy is really becoming a concept that helps companies directly just to, you know, have material flows that are, you know, good for the bottom line. Mm-hmm. But also circular economy is a way for companies to reach other goals. It can help, you know, choose materials that help companies to go towards climate targets, emission targets, or SDGs, sustainable development goals, for example. And so I think it's a manifestation of how much circular economy is of interest to those ends, the different organizations.
So if we were to take a closer look at the Circulytics as a tool itself, if you were to describe it, let's say, briefly in 1 minute, so what is Circulytics and what does it entail?
Right, okay. So what a company would see is a sign-up form, first of all, going to then a process where we give an account to an online platform where companies would put in data on these metrics, indicators, and
so
then submit.
That's the process to go through. But the tool itself, what does it entail?
Right. So then what happens when we get the data, the tool is essentially taking in data from companies and then calculating based on that data a single score. So the tool provides an independent view of a company's circular economy performance, so to speak, by the Ellen MacArthur Foundation based on calculating a single score that breaks down into several categories then for a company. And so the output of the tool for companies is a scorecard that we produce.
And we look at enablers and material flows, right?
Yes, so the two big categories are enablers, which describes the elements that are key into transforming or transitioning from a linear way of doing business to a more circular one. Things like, is circular economy part of your strategy? And then outcomes, which in most cases is about material flows. So how circular actually are your material flows? The outcomes of all the enablers you've put in place, in a way.
And the score, what's the actual score? Is it like a letter, a number?
Yes, yeah, it is a letter.
A letter.
It's an indication, so it's an indicative letter of how well a company is doing. And that single letter score, for example, an A, will then break down into these categories, enablers and outcomes, and the themes that then lie within there. So we give a little bit more granularity in the score to see what are areas of strength and places to improve.
So if I were a company if I filled in Circulytics, I would get one score for enablers and one score for my material flows and outcomes. And then the combined score would be my circularity score.
That's right.
Great. Yeah. And how was it for you? Did you find any questions particularly challenging? Any questions that it was hard to find data for?
So overall, it was a really interesting thought exercise. It definitely wasn't too onerous, maybe a day's work for us. And we had much of the data already. So if you filled in your frameworks like CDP or anything GRI related, you'll have a lot of the information you need already. The rest of it is available in your annual filings. If you do an annual sustainability report, you'll be able to do a lot of this, provide a lot of this data. So it's just a question of understanding how that can be applied in a circular economy context. So particularly challenging questions, though, we did have on the people and skills section. That was something really hard for us to wrap our heads around, because we didn't know where to draw the line of just who has a circular economy implementation job. You know, is that the entire company because we're a circular model, or is that just the R&D team? So we went back and forth and had a good internal discussion of what we thought that meant. But that was definitely the hardest question for us to answer.
So in terms of different industries wanting to get the circularity score, does it matter which industry you're from? Would that affect the score?
It affects potentially the indicators that a company will see when they use the online platform. For example, a services company that doesn't have material flows, we wouldn't ask about material flow questions. So it does affect to a certain extent.
Okay, so if it was, for instance, a fossil fuels company filling in the Circulytics score, what would be the highest score they could potentially get?
Right, so it's an interesting question, and indeed we don't exclude per se any companies, but if your material flows are fully linear, it will, of course, show in the score. But even if you are a company that is, for example, extractive business, it's possible that companies are shifting priority to away from that and to different business models. And I think Circulytics can be a tool to sort of guide or give ideas, inspiration on what that could look like. What does it look like for a mining company to go to urban mining, for example, and how that sort of can be a part of a circular economy?
And so let's hear from two company representatives. We'll hear from Marianne Richaud from Brambles and also Gavin Warner from Unilever.
So we've used Circulytics internally to compare it to our internal measurement systems. We've used it also to design our 2025 sustainability targets, and namely, in particular, the inputs and outputs part of it. The enablers were quite set in stone, so it was really the inputs and outputs that were really interesting. Using it forward in the future, well, we'll use Circulytics to measure progress against our 2025 objectives to carbon neutral. And we'll also share externally as well this score and this evolution.
Yeah, I think trying to understand how we're doing as a business on the journey of circularity is super useful in trying to benchmark yourself to say, look, how far do we have to go? It's great that we've part of the CE100, it's great that we're part of the new plastics economy, and it's fantastic that we're innovating towards a circular economy. But unless we start to understand, well, how far are we on this? How advanced are we on this? You know, we're just kind of doing things and hoping we'll end up somewhere. So it's good to have a measure and start to say, what are the levers can we play in the organization to accelerate our journey?
I find it really fascinating to hear, especially from Marianne, how that tool has helped them to set the targets for 2025, and they're going to use that tool to measure their performance against these targets. And Tom, it would be really interesting to hear about DS Smith's experience. So having received your beta score, has it started any internal conversations? Have you made any different decisions in terms of circular economy implementation?
Absolutely, yes. I'd like to echo what Marianne and Gavin were saying in those videos. That's very true of what we're using those, using our feedback for. So yeah, I mean, we, I'm not sure, so we had a B plus when we got ours, which I would have been happy with when I was in school. But that we did some prompts and internal conversations, and some which were, oh, that's good, and some feedback was, well, I thought we'd be better than that because of our circular model. Just highlights to show the different understandings of what circular economy means, even within a business which has a circular model. So, yeah, we've definitely been using it at the moment to feed into our strategy review process. I'm sure many organizations, representatives and those watching, look at their strategy and, you know, review that to make sure it's still future fit. Well, that's where ours is fitting in now, in particular on the people and skills section of it. We're really thinking about how do we invest in our people? How do we train them up to deliver the circular economy? What changes do we need in design, in reprocessing, in collections, in operations? How does it all fit together? So that's very much feeding into what new discussions we're having now, but it's still very much an internal focus for us.
Well, talking about the future then, so what's next for Circulytics? What would be Circulytics 2.0?
So 2.0, we are putting together now a group within our network to work on different topics. DS Smith, of course, is also part of that group. And we have several work streams we're working on to make the user experience better, make the backend algorithm work smoother, and make the content more relevant for a broader set of companies, working on service providers, with reverse cycle companies, etc. And we plan to launch this in October this year.